Okay, then next up are Iwona Krawczyk and Jagoda Marszałek, joining us from Poland, from the Institute of Polish Language of the Polish Academy of Sciences. And they will be talking about first medieval Latin Transcribathon from Polish sources, and they will present this project with the help of a video they made that Miriam is starting in a few seconds, and will be available for questions afterwards because they are joining us online via Zoom.
First medieval Latin Transcribathon from Polish sources. Our Transcribathon is a short-term transcription challenge consisting of rewriting medieval manuscripts into a machine-readable format. The project is volunteer-based, involves the amateurs of old handwritten script, and uses the tools of modern digital paleography. The aim was threefold: to acquire new texts important for Polish medieval researchers, to prepare the training material for the creation of the new HDR models for Latin. We also wanted to build an interdisciplinary team of enthusiasts of medieval Latin paleography, as we know how many interesting projects are born from collaboration based on shared passion. We intended the whole challenge to be both an opportunity to test our own editing skills, to learn something new, to meet interesting people, and simply to enjoy the experiment. In our project, we wanted to employ tools available in the public domain. For this reason, we chose the Transcribus platform to transcribe the manuscripts, and for the transcription, we decided to use public fonts from MUFI. Characters were selected from the MUFI public area to avoid font display problems. If a particular symbol, although suitable for the text, was not available in the MUFI open access, substitute characters were introduced, which may be replaced in the future. The work is divided into two stages, during which project participants work both individually and in teams to transcribe individual pages. Detailed instructions were prepared for each stage of transcription in order to streamline the work. Transcription guidelines have been prepared in advance, but the list of rules remains open until the project is completed. Our project takes place online. The source materials are available on the website of the Central Archive of Historical Records in Warsaw and on the Transcribus platform when the entire two-stage transcription and proofreading of the documents is carried out. All resource materials are available to participants on Google Drive. Communication between the participants takes place via email, Zoom, and mainly Slack. The final result of the project, the edited documents, will be published in digital format on the eFontes project website. The choice of source material was dictated by the relative scarcity of documents of this kind in the corpus of Polish medieval Latin. Finally, we selected 11 documents from the Polish Crown Chancery Public Register from the mid-15th century, which gave a total of almost 1,000 lines for transcription. We disseminated information about the project in early August with a deadline for applications of 5th September. A total of 24 people from different backgrounds from Poland, Ukraine, UK and Moldova signed up to participate. The project started on 15th September with an organizational meeting where we presented its main objectives, the working methods and met the participants. On the second day, there were two introductory training sessions on Latin paleography and on the Transcribus platform. We have also provided additional videos and training material to assist in the use of this program. On that day, the first stage of transcription began, which involved reproducing the graphic side of the document as closely as possible using MUFI Unicodes to denote medieval abbreviations. In order to make transcription easier to the project participants, a special keyboard was prepared containing the fonts selected for the project. After a week's work, the second stage began, consisting of proofreading the transcription of teammates and editing the above transcription with the development of abbreviations. The next stage concerns the proofreading of all versions of the documents by us, the project organizers. On the last day of the project, we plan to hold a closing meeting where we will discuss the results of our work. Shortly afterwards, we plan to publish the editions of the eFontes website, together with detailed information about its authorship. We also want to archive our challenge in a format typical of digital projects and publish the finally adopted transcription rules in open access repositories. The HDR training material developed with Transcribus will be then used to create a new Latin model that will serve us to extract the text from remaining documents of similar type. The opportunity to collaborate with other paleographers, often real experts in the field, in turn offers the hope of using this experience in future collaborative projects. First medieval Latin transcribathon from Polish sources. Our transcribathon is a short-term...
Okay, the video wants to go on a loop. Yeah, big dziękuję, or thank you to Poland for your very nice video. About this very interesting topic too, because I know that Poland has a very rich history when it comes to Latin as opposed to other Slavonic nations. And it's really cool how you've been working on this language and its transcription. Are there any questions for our Polish participants? Okay.
So it just flashed over the screen, but I've seen a bestiary among the sources you transcribed. And I suppose that there are even many images. And what did you do with them?
Thank you for the question, and thank you for having us there. Good afternoon, by the way. The bestiary you saw was just an image to show, it was a meme made from the open sources manuscripts provided by one of European museums. So we don't use, we don't have those images in our documents. They are just chancellery documents. So this is plain text with a lot of glosses, Latin glosses and Polish glosses, but unfortunately no images. We would like to have them though.
Thank you.